Tenaliraman and the Thieves. The ruler of Vijayanagar, King Krishnadevaraya, was an able administrator. He was kind and just even to his prisoners. Once when he was on a regular survey of the jail, two thieves asked for mercy, pleading that they could be helped to the king. "We are experts in the field of theft, your majesty," said the thieves, "and can help you in catching other thieves. Please appoint us as your spies. We promise to serve you sincerely." The king was in confusion whether to believe them or not. After a little thought, the king said, "All right, if you are real experts in theft, then try to rob my witty court jester, Tenaliraman. If you succeed, I will appoint you as my spies." The two thieves accepted the challenge and were set free for the night. That night, they went to Tenaliraman's house and hid behind a tree outside the courtyard. "Be careful, friend," one of them said to the other. "Tenaliraman is said to be very clever. Ha ha ha. Tonight he will know," laughed the other. After a while, Tenaliraman came out of his house to water the plants. Suddenly, he spotted some figures behind the tree. It did not take much time for the wise man to realize that they were thieves hiding behind the trees. But he remained quiet as if he had not seen anything. Then he went inside the house and called out loudly to his wife. "Did you hear, dear? Two thieves have run away from the jail. We have to be careful. Quickly make a bundle of all the coins, jewels and valuables." The thieves were overhearing. Then Tenaliraman carried a heavy bundle out of his house and threw it into the well in his backyard. "Ah, here are our valuables. We'll be safe," he murmured. As was expected, the thieves had been secretly watching all this. They felt very excited. As soon as Tenaliraman and his wife went inside the house, the thieves came to the well. "There is water in the well," they whispered. So they began to draw water and throw it out so that they could go down the well and fetch the bundle. As the thieves were busy drawing water from the well, Tenaliraman silently crept out of his house, covering his head with a shawl. He took a shovel and began to dig furrows in the ground to guide the flow of water towards his plants. After hours and hours of hard work, the thieves were finally able to bring out the bundle. But all they could find in it were stones and pebbles. "Oh no," they cried in shock. "We have been fooled. That Tenaliraman is really clever. He has tricked us." They fled from there but were caught by the soldiers. "Ha ha ha. There is no one who can trick Tenaliraman," said the king. The two thieves were sent back to the jail with a severe punishment for making false claims. Never again did they boast of their expertise.